Hi all, electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will program the voltage relay, which I looked at in the last video. We will also test the operation of this relay when the input voltage changes. To do this, we will use a variable autotransformer from the SUNTEK company. We'll look at installing the relay in the shield in the next video. So as not to miss this video, subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Variable autotransformer is abbreviated as variac. Using variac, we can change the supply voltage to the load in the range from 0 to 300 volts, thereby testing our load at different voltages. Variable autotransformer differs from dimmers in that it can regulate a more powerful load without distorting the sinusoidal shape of the mains voltage signal. And this allows it to be used not only for testing devices, but for applied purposes in everyday life, which we will talk about in future videos. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss them. This variac regulates voltage from 0 to 300 volts, output current up to 4A. The variac input is connected to the mains voltage. Our voltage relay is connected from the variac output. A light bulb is connected from the voltage relay output, with which we will control the state of the voltage relay output, and we will also see the brightness of the lamp when the network voltage is exceeded and decreased. We set the LATR to 230 volts and begin programming the voltage relay. Let's turn on our system. When turned on for the first time, the voltage relay tests the network for a period of time determined by parameter A1. This is a time of 10 seconds after which the relay turns on the load. Press the set button. Mode A1 is turned on. This is the delay time for the first switch on. The default is 10 seconds. We leave this value. If we want to set a different value, we can do this using the up and down keys. That is, we increase it this way, we reduce it this way. Holding these keys for a long time turns on the mode of accelerated adjustment of these parameters. Press the set button again. Programming parameter A2 is turned on. This is the overvoltage response voltage. Since 2015, the voltage in the Russian network has been adopted at 230 volts. Maximum deviation 10%. That is, the voltage in the network can be in the range from 207 to 253 volts. I took the trigger voltage with a small margin and set it to 260 volts. Press the set button again. The next mode is A3. This is the voltage after which the load switching process is activated. The relay holds the time determined by parameter A4 and turns on the load. We set it to 255 volts. The next parameter is A4. Load turn on time after voltage restoration. Default is 30 seconds. I'm leaving him. This time is suitable for most home network devices. The next parameter is A5. Overvoltage response time. Default is 1 second. But, if overvoltage occurs, the equipment can burn out very quickly. So I make this time minimum for this relay 0.1 second. The next parameter is A6. Undervoltage trip voltage. The minimum voltage in the network, as I said, should be no lower than 207 volts. We make the adjustment with a small margin and set it to 200 volts. The next parameter is A7. This is the voltage after which the load switching process is activated. The relay holds the time determined by parameter A8 and turns on the load. We set it to 205 volts. The next parameter is A8. Load turn on time after voltage restoration. Default is 30 seconds. I'm leaving him. This time is also suitable for most home network devices. The next parameter is A9. This is the response time at reduced voltage. Default is 1 second. We leave this value. Motors do not burn out immediately when the voltage drops. Plus, this compensates for the temporary drop in voltage when starting the engine. The next parameter is A10. The maximum current after which the relay turns off the load. Usually the default current is the same as the rated current of the relay. For this relay it is 40A. For me, This relay will work in tandem with a 16A circuit breaker. Therefore, I set this parameter to 16A. I explained in more detail why I put it this way in the previous video. You will find the link in the description. The next parameter is A11. Delay time for turning on the relay after current triggering. I'll leave him. The next parameter is A12. Current relay response time. By default, it costs 0.5 seconds. I increase this time to 1 second. This compensates for inrush currents when devices are turned on. Plus, we also have a circuit breaker for current protection. The next parameter is A13. Correcting the readings of the built-in voltmeter. My relay and multimeter readings differ by 1 volt. I decided not to touch him. If you have a standard voltmeter, you can adjust it. We have configured the voltage relay. Now we will check its work. Turn on the light bulb. First, we reduce the voltage from the variac. When the voltage is less than 200 volts, the light bulb turns off. The low voltage indicator lights up. The digital indicator alternately shows the mains voltage and LV. What does low voltage mean? We increase the voltage on the variac. At a level of more than 205 volts, the time countdown starts. The relay tests the network and connects the load. Here we have a light bulb connected. We continue to increase the voltage on the variac. Please note, the light bulb is burning brighter and brighter. And it's about to burn. But when the voltage is more than 260 volts, the voltage relay turns off the load. At the same time, the high voltage indicator lights up. And the digital indicator alternately shows the network voltage and HV. What does high voltage or increased voltage mean? Again, we lower the voltage on the variac. When the voltage is less than 255, the voltage relay turns on a countdown counter, during which it tests the network and turns on the load. Before turning on, now our light bulb has turned on. To check the relay operating current, we use an iron. I'll connect it now. We set the operating current to 8 amperes. So that it is lower than the current that the iron consumes. That's it, we programmed 8 amperes. Here we have the iron turned on. The relay tripped due to overcurrent. It will count down 30 seconds and attempt to turn on our network again. But, since we did not turn off the iron, the relay will turn off the load again within a second. So the process will be repeated until we turn off the iron. We turned off the iron. Let's see. Since the increased load is turned off, our voltage relay does not work. But let's reprogram the voltage relay again to 16A. Since it will be installed in the panel. This is parameter A10. We set it to 16 amps. We have checked all relay parameters. It passed all tests. The voltage relay is ready for installation in the panel. In the next video, I will install this voltage relay into the panel. Subscribe to the channel and click on the bell so you don't miss this video. And of course, I will be grateful for your likes, reposts and comments. See you in old and new videos. Bye.